So, James, what's been your highlight so far of this conference, Trust and Litigation in Athens?
It's a difficult one to pick, actually, I think, Rachel. We had some fantastic sessions today, but my highlight, I think, probably was the session on anti-Bartlett, which went extremely well and led to a fantastic amount of debate amongst the attendees at the conference. How about you? What was your highlight of the day?
Yeah, I mean, they've all been incredibly good and unexpectedly diverse sort of subject areas. I loved the important life and death decision cases. We had the head of legal at Great Ormond Street who came in and talked about some of the issues they've faced with some really high profile cases. And then the panel went on to look at the media and the courts and how they deal with these things. It was fascinating.
This event in particular is probably one of my favourites because it's more relaxed, which I think enables people to share more and more freely. So you actually end up getting more out of them, I think, than you would do from a more formal setting. The social side is key in all of these things because in the real world, our work comes from our fellow practitioners in different jurisdictions. So meeting people, getting to know them, that's how you develop your business. Great for our firms and it's great for us as individuals as well.
The most interesting session today, and it's just day one, is possibly the plate smashing in the Greek restaurant that's yet to come, which we're all looking forward to. But to try to be a bit more serious, I very much enjoyed the session about the mental capacity and the recent cases in England which have dealt with extremely difficult situations for parents faced with hospitals who want to cease treatment for a badly brain damaged baby. And looking at that from the perspective of a lawyer who worked for Great Ormond Street Hospital, a lawyer who has worked for families, was very interesting.
Well, what's really nice about this conference is it's a collection of really mainly quite young, but not just young, I'm not young, people, all of whom are real enthusiasts for trust litigation. And that's something I've been doing all my time as a lawyer, and I'm now doing in the Supreme Court and the Privy Council. And the sense of enthusiasm and cheerfulness about it all here is something really exciting, and I shall go away and enjoy the memory of it for some considerable time.
There's lots of relevant case law that's being discussed. There's lots of uncertainties in this area of law, so it's good to hear other people's thoughts and some of the debates that are going on and keep current and fresh yourself on some of the really pertinent topics that are troubling us in this area of law. So
I think the great thing about this conference is that a lot of the people we work with regularly get together in one place for a number of days and really have the opportunity to catch up, to share ideas, be together in the same place for a number of days, which really allows you to catch up in a way you don't normally get the chance to do in our crazy busy lives back home.
It's been great chairing the Trust in Litigation Conference, and it's been really interesting to be involved in planning it, working out the programme, working with the other chairs. And one of the best things about it is the fact that we have made sure throughout that there's a mixture of different speakers, senior and junior, and I think that's encouraged the participation from the audience, because whether you're senior or junior in the audience, you've known that there's someone who's a similar level to you and you've not felt embarrassed to say something. And it's just been great to have that interactive side of the conference, which you don't necessarily always get.